Básicamente estamos en una de las zonas donde existe la mayor diversidad de anfibios y reptiles de todo el planeta. Hay una gran
We're in one of the
concentración
zones where you have the highest diversity of amphibians and reptiles of the whole planet. This zone, comprised primarily of flooded and highly humid ecosystems, harbors a high diversity that is still not completely understood for Peru and Ecuador, despite the fact that studies of Amazonia in these two countries have been taking place for the last 25 to 30 years. We're still lacking a lot of knowledge of this flooded zone, which is a very important ecosystem to be surveyed. It is our hope that, beyond this rapid inventory, eventually a long-term study will permit us to have more extensive knowledge about the species present in this zone. To conduct a rapid inventory, we do visual surveys of encounters, which entails walking a determined amount of time for a set distance. On average, we travel daily 1 kilometer or 500 meters, more or less, with about 3 to 4 hours of nighttime searches and about 2 to 3 hours of searching during the morning, which permit us to obtain many types of groups of amphibians and reptiles. Our most important findings during this inventory are species, for example, like Amphisbaena alba, which is a species well known throughout the Amazon that you normally don't find in the rapid inventories. It is difficult to collect because it has a fossorial behavior, meaning that it lives in holes in the ground. This time we were fortunate to observe one. It is the legless lizard without appendages. Among the others, the Osteocephalus, we have found several species of this frog. And in Camp 3, we found Osteocephalus yasuni and Osteocephalus fusifacis. There are frog species that were only recently discovered and described. I think that Osteocephalus yasuni was discovered in 2003. And Osteocephalus fusifacis in 2004. Their species are not well known, and we have found several individuals. For example, the Botrachopias ioprora snake. This is the first time that I have found one, that I could see it in the wild, in its natural state. And we can't forget about the frog Ranfofrine festi, which is the new record for Peru. It is a species of frog that, in theory, belongs to the south central part of Ecuador and the northeastern part of Peru. In Peru, we also found a species of the genus Ranfofrine that also occurs in Ecuador and the other species of Ranfofrine that belong in Colombia. This species is not Ranfofrine festi, and in any case, it is a new record for Peru, and it is possible that it may be a species that has never been described.